God we serve.
King.
He is the King of Kings. He is the Lord of Lords. His name is Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh. Grasshoppers,
That's how big our God is. We're like grasshoppers. But he's even greater than that. It says, he stretches out the heavens like a canopy. He took the heavens and made a canopy. And then it says, he spreads them out like a tent to live in. He brings princes to naught and reduces rulers to nothing. So the people in charge, they're of no consequence. A lot of people have paid attention to the rulers of nations and the president and all those different things. But God is over everything. He's over everyone. So they have no consequence to them. They can't do anything to us because we belong to God. Amen?
Amen.
Amen. And then it says, no sooner than they are planted, no sooner than they grow root in the ground, as soon as they get established over a short period of time, it's only a minute before God blows his breath on them and they wither up. You know, and then the wind sweeps away and we don't hear no more about them.
Yeah.
Nobody talk about them anymore.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
But we are still here. We talk about the love of Jesus Christ because he is the one that stands over everything.
Yeah.
It says, to whom will you compare me?
Yeah.
Who can you compare to God?
No one.
No one. Who can you compare him to? It says, who created all these things?
Yeah.
He who brings out the starry heaven, and he brings out the stars one by one,
yeah,
and calls each one of them by name.
Yeah.
He named all the stars. He says, because of his great and mighty strength, not one star is missing.
Yeah.
They can't even be lost.
Yeah.
The stars, even when we can't see them, we can't count them.
Yeah.
We just know that God has them. He has every one of them in his control by name. Just like every one of us. You stars in here.
Yeah.
He knows each and every one of us by name. Such a great God. He says, why do you complain, O Jacob? Why do you say, Israel, my way is hidden from the Lord? Because my cause is disgraced by God. Do you not know? Have you not heard? The Lord is the everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth.
Yeah.
He will not grow tired or weary. His understanding no one can fathom. He gives strength and increases power to the weak. So a God of that much power, you know he gives love.
Yeah.
He loves us so much that each and every one of us, he thinks about it. He brings power and he brings love and peace and strength to us when we're weak. The Bible says when we are weak, he is made strong.
Yeah.
So I know that he reaches down and he says, you know, I'm going to put my power in each and every last one of you. And it's by his power that we're able to live and breathe and move. And not only that, but it says, when the young ones grow tired and weary, even when they grow weary, and young men stumble and fall, but those who have their hope in the Lord will renew their strength. So when they get tired, we teach them what we've been taught throughout our years. Trust in the Lord.
Yeah.
He is our strength.
Yeah.
Trust in God.
Yeah.
For he loves us and he cares for us.
Yes,
it says, they will soar on wings like eagles. So when they have their trust in the Lord, they can go out and do mighty things. Just like we can. Even you, those of you who are up in age, you can do whatever you desire because God has given you strength. He said, when you go to him and you seek his strength, he will give you strength to mount up on wings as eagles.
Yeah.
You know, you will run and not be weary.
Yeah.
You will grow and not faint.
Yeah.
Amen. You will run and not faint.
Yeah.
But a God just that mighty. Sometimes we take a look back and say, God has all this power. He's too powerful. I don't need to bug him with my little things, the things that I desire in my life. I want to just be able to go over here and do this. But God is just that loving. You know, he counted each and every star. So he knows each of us by name. And he loves us so much. Every one of us, each and every one of us, so much that he sent his son, his one and only son, to die for us. So just thinking about him giving the power, his power to us each and every day as we need it. He says, you might my child, my son, my daughter, you need a little bit of power. I have unlimited source of power. So what is it to me to give you just a little bit of power? So our God, just that, let's not lose sight of the fact that he is all powerful, yet loving enough to think about each and every last one of us. So none of you have been forgotten. None of you have been forgotten by God. Even down to the littlest child, he thinks of each and every last one of us. That's a loving, caring God. That is true. That is a true God that you can have somebody that you believe in, that knows of you. You think about your children and your mothers and your fathers when they gave you birth or when you gave birth to your children. You remember each and every last one of them. Amen. So when they came to you and they needed something or you needed something from your parents, you said, I need. And they gave it to you, right? Because they loved you so much. But yet, whatever it is that they need, your children needed, they knew that you had the power to give them. So just think of God as our Father, that whatever we need, we can bring it to him. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. God bless you.
God, amen. Isn't he great?
Yeah.
How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? All to see how great is our God.
How great is our God? Sing with me, how great is our God? All see how great is our God?
How great is our God?
Sing with me.
sing.
And my heart will sing. How great is our God.
Nunca cese de adorar. escuchas, Señor, toda la creación. Canta, Señor, toda la creación. Montañas dirán y el mar rugirá al sonar de tu nombre. Canto con gozo al mirar tu poder. Por siempre te amaré, por siempre diré incomparables promesas me das, Señor. Incomparables son tus promesas, incomparables, Señor. Incomparable. Abre mis ojos, oh Cristo.
Father God, in the name of Jesus, we thank you for this opportunity to share your words, your songs with these people, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Heavenly Father, that you've given us all another day of life and health and strength, oh Heavenly Father. Father, help us, oh Heavenly Father, to just search our hearts and always find something to be thankful for, oh Heavenly Father. In this season of Thanksgiving, oh Heavenly Father, we give thanks to you, we give thanks to one another, we give thanks to all who have concern for us, in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. God bless you. Happy Thanksgiving.